So, on a class trip in the beginning of this year, my friends and I were playing a game. And that game required them to label me as a superhero. In around 10 seconds, all the results came in, and every single one said something along the lines of feminist girl. One even just said feminazi. For as long as I can remember, I've been labeled the crazy feminist spewing liberal propaganda in people's faces when all I needed to learn how to do was take a joke. Now, I could say I know where my friends are coming from, but honestly, I don't. I was raised in a house of women, ready to call anyone out on their bullcrap. Being a feminist, to me, just meant the same as knowing that we're all entitled to the same things. Being a feminist was the same as being human. Now, before 65% of the audience decides I'm already wrong, why don't we talk about what feminism is to me and how I use it? The feminism I was taught is based on three things: equity, intersectionality, and autonomy. Now, these words may sound big and scary, but really they're simple. Autonomy is the right to govern yourself, to be free in thought and action. Intersectionality is the complex, cumulative way in which multiple forms of discrimination intersect, especially in the experiences of marginalized individuals. And equity is the justness and fairness in treating individuals. Basically, as a feminist, I believe that all of us have the right to control our minds and actions, that all of us experience varying degrees of oppression, and that to overcome that oppression, we must be treated equitably. Now, thinking like this makes me judge things, things that some people laugh at and others just look at as normal. When I see a dress code that's different for women than it is for men, I know that it's the result of a patriarchal value system. And it disappoints me. It disappoints me because on an institutional level, we recognize that women are just distracting things if they're not wearing acceptable clothing. I mean, I've never heard of or seen teachers tug on a boy's shirt because his vest is showing, or tell him that his shorts are too short, or even just to tidy his hair. When you tell a girl to go home because her clothes don't fit into the definition of what somebody else deems appropriate, what you're telling her, the message you're sending her is that her education is less important than someone else's. That she should change who she is and what she's comfortable in so as not to inconvenience someone else. When I see hairstyles that are deemed more appropriate than others, then I know that it's an after effect of colonization. Hairstyles more suited to the smooth, straight hair is deemed work appropriate, whereas hairstyles more suited to the frizzy, curly hair that a chunk of the Indian population has in tandem with people from Africa and the Caribbean and other places is deemed inappropriate and messy. And what you have to realize is a woman with frizzy hair faces a judgment system that's biased against her ethnicity and intersectionally, her gender. But it's not even just that simple. Our presentation of ourselves as women is inherently complex, beyond individual choices. We don't understand this, but the patriarchal value system constrains us in our thoughts and actions. It traps us in a situation where the discourse of sexuality is presented through a male gaze. We aren't given a choice. We're objectified. Our bodies are commodities, separate from ourselves. And us, as women, we propagate these ideas. We normalize roles that demand we sacrifice ourselves for the benefit of others. How many times have you asked the question, how do you juggle your work life and your home life? More importantly, how many times have you asked that question of a man? Women, in the eyes of society, are seen as mothers most of the time. Mothers that give us unconditional love and care and labor. Labor that they don't get any pay for. Women spend 2 times as much time on domestic chores globally as men do. In India, domestic chores are seen as a woman's responsibility solely. And it's not like this just affects women. I mean, the patriarchal value system assigns roles to women that it deems feminine, belittles and labels less than, and it contrasts these to roles that are labeled masculine. It fails to recognize that traits such as empathy and kindness and fierceness are not gendered, they are just human. Some are not less than others. Only one in every seven engineers are women. Only 31.9% of students of engineering in India are women. In the United States, it was seen that only 42% of those looking for an MA in the arts or humanities were men. It seems clear to me that this is the result of the indoctrination of the masses. Women are supposed to be soft and artistic and emotional, and men are supposed to be gruff and scientific and reasonable. Men aren't supposed to experience emotion out loud. They're supposed to suppress their emotions. They're supposed to be disjointed from them. And when they want to express them, they're deemed abnormal. Globally, men are 1.7 times more likely to commit suicide than women. Time and time again, we see people, women and men alike, internalize these patterns of thinking. I mean, I find myself do it sometimes. I'll think things like, wow, she's showing a lot of skin, or wow, he throws like a girl, or even I don't believe he's crying. And then I'll have to jolt myself into thinking straight. I'll have to remind myself that she can wear exactly what she wants, that gender has nothing to do with how to throw a ball, regardless of what I've been told, and that he can cry when and where he wants. The only way to stop this destructive pattern of thinking is to radically change the system, to make it one which is equitable, where you and I are treated as individuals. Individuals who can dress as they please and express what they want. Where we're not objects. Where we're not designed to behave a certain way simply because of how we identify. Feminism demands we ask questions. Questions like, why is a system that's so clearly derogatory taken to be natural or normal? And why do people from everywhere seem so resistant to change it? It makes us conscious of the unjust game we're playing and empowers us to look for alternatives to minimize or eliminate even the injustices that we face. Now, maybe one day we'll live in a world that's just and equal. For right now, I hope everyone here takes home the message that maybe feminist girl isn't a half bad idea for a superhero. I mean, maybe she could change the world. Thank you.